U.S. natural gas is a widely adopted alternative fuel in our nation's transportation energy portfolio. This clean, domestically produced fuel is used in a wide array of vehicles across the country.
Natural gas tanks can be used in vehicles from very small to very large, and they can be in passenger cars all the way up to Class 8 over-the-road trucks. They can be used in trash trucks, buses, delivery trucks. They cover a very wide marketplace.
Today, some of the earliest adopters of compressed natural gas are taking the important next steps to safely decommission CNG tanks before they reach their expiration dates and the end of their useful lives. Clean Cities coalitions nationwide are a key resource for information and guidance.
Clean Cities is a Department of Energy program with nearly 100 coordinators around the country. Those coordinators are working with fleets to help cut petroleum use within transportation.
This government industry initiative for the safety of the CNG fuel tanks was led by the U.S. Department of Energy's Clean Cities program.
Clean Cities is partnering with transportation organizations to ensure expiring tanks are properly removed and, in some cases, replaced to keep CNG vehicles safely on the road for years to come.
The U.S. Department of Transportation's role in this government industry initiative is that there are over 10,000 CNG transit buses on the road, and some of them, the early ones that were deployed in the late 90s and early 2000s, have CNG fuel tank cylinders that are coming up against an expiration date.
CSA is a not-for-profit standards development organization and testing and certification agency as well. CNG tanks are designed in accordance to CSA NGB2, which is an industry standard, and it has a finite life on tank design. It can be 15, 20, or up to 25 years in service, but at the end of that lifetime, it needs to be decommissioned and disposed of.
Generally, this will start with the recognition that your tanks are nearing the end of their useful life, and each tank is labeled with an expiration date.
It is important to know the expiration date for every CNG tank in your fleet. Again, the useful life of most is 15, 20, or 25 years.
There is a label. It's required by the Department of Transportation, DOT, what they call FMVSS 304. It's a label that tells when the tank was built and when its end of life is, when it does expire.
Look for full information on the tank. Labels on the tank typically include a do not use after date. There should also be a label with the expiration date on the vehicle itself. It's also a good idea to document those dates in advance and use that record as part of your fleet maintenance plan. Depending on your approach, you may need to procure new tanks in advance and plan for vehicles to be briefly out of service for tank decommissioning or plan for proper vehicle disposal.
Natural gas has been a key element of Metro in the past almost 20 years, meeting our emissions requirements and helping clean up the air in Los Angeles. Our fleet is 100% natural gas.
To keep those alternative fueled vehicles safely in use involves regular inspection.
Unspraying tanks, make sure they're not leaking.
If the vehicle were in an accident or there was a fire, right then you have to inspect the tanks before you put them back into service.
Look for damage to the tanks, signs of wear or corrosion, and make sure to schedule maintenance every 3 years or 36,000 miles.
We fill it up with 50 pounds of nitrogen, check for leaks, and then we take it out to the fuel station.
Tank inspection is also required after any fire, accident, or incident that could cause damage to the vehicle. If the tank is mounted under the vehicle and a driver hits a curb or debris on the road strikes the underbody, immediate inspection is necessary. To find a certified inspector, visit the CSA Group website and search for certified CNG fuel system inspectors. Remember, damaged tanks and tanks at the end of their labeled life cycle cannot be recertified. They must be permanently removed from service.
And it could have a failure. And so what we're trying to do is prevent failures from in-service tanks that have now reached their end of life.
Because compressed natural gas tanks are pressurized, it's vital to take the appropriate precautions when maintaining, replacing, and disposing of the tanks, improper handling can be hazardous.
One of the things we've learned at Metro is you don't need to be scared of natural gas, but you do need to respect it.
There are three key steps to removing a CNG fuel tank from service: defueling, decommissioning, and disposal. It's an important best practice to document and track the workflow for each of these steps to ensure the work is completed safely. This chapter provides an overview of how to safely defuel a compressed natural gas fuel tank. It covers these critical steps: inspection of the fuel system, defueling the tank, and verification and documentation of completed defueling.
The process starts by defueling the system, right? We need to make sure and be 100% confident that we've removed all of the fuel from the vehicle.
Defueling begins with pre-inspection to make sure the process can move forward safely. Wear personal protective equipment, follow the manufacturer's guidelines, and be certain the technicians are highly trained on compressed natural gas tank defueling.
You want somebody that is qualified and skilled in operating on high-pressure natural gas systems in order to make sure that that vehicle and that fuel tank has been defueled properly.
Inspect the lines, valves, and other fuel system components for damage or leaks to make sure the frame or the tank mounting system is intact.
We'll inspect the bus, make sure there's no broken bolts, that the frame's not rusted out. We'll then take and defuel the bus, get rid of all the natural gases in the tanks themselves.
It's safest to defuel the tank while it's still secure on the vehicle. The vehicle or the tank, if already removed, should be earth grounded.
We ground the bus, then we connect the hose to defuel it.
Make sure there's a proper connection between the vehicle and the fuel panel before the valve is opened and defueling begins. The time it takes to properly defuel a CNG vehicle depends on how many fuel tanks are on board and how large they are. Defueling time ranges from an hour or two for smaller vehicles with just a tank or two to as long as 12 hours for large trucks and buses with several racks of tanks.
After we defuel it here, we go and we check it manually, each one, make sure that they're all empty. That's the most important thing.
There are a couple of approved defueling methods.
The preferred method is to be able to draw it back into the storage system that is at the station. The second way you can do it, and it's approved, is through a vent stack that can be vented above a building.
Be aware that using a vent stack is not ideal because it vents methane, a greenhouse gas, to the atmosphere. Using a flare stack, while uncommon in defueling applications, can mitigate these greenhouse gas impacts. In either case, the technician uses a gauge to check pressure. Once initial defueling is complete, the tank is prepared for final venting to remove residual compressed natural gas. At this point, there should be no more than 400 to 500 PSI remaining. The vehicle, or the tank if it's removed, and the vent pipe are grounded, and an electrically conductive hose is hooked up to the defueling port on the vehicle.
There's still pressure left in the fuel tank, so what we're doing is we're gonna vent the rest of it out.
Removing the residual CNG can take up to a couple of hours. It's important that all work take place in a CNG-approved maintenance area and that workers are rehearsed in safety and evacuation procedures.
Those facilities are equipped with a methane detection system. If there's a leak inside the building from a bus, we have detectors in the roof because natural gas rises up to the roof. It will detect the methane and set off an alarm depending on how much concentration there is.
Remember, it's an important best practice to verify that each step is completed properly before moving on. This chapter provides an overview of compressed natural gas fuel tank decommissioning, which includes these steps: verification of completed defueling, removing of the valve from the tank, removal of the tank from the vehicle, purging, destroying, and decommissioning the tank, and verification and documentation of completed decommissioning. Once the compressed natural gas tank and fuel lines are defueled and verified through your workflow procedure, it's time to first remove the valve from the tank and then the tank from the vehicle.
There are unique servicing procedures that should be followed by each transit agency.
Be sure to follow the manufacturer recommendations and the facility's established procedures. Technicians will again need to wear personal protective equipment and a safety harness for fall protection when working on top of a vehicle.
You want to follow a manufacturer recommended procedure. If you do not follow that, then you could run into issues where the fuel tank itself might not have been downed properly, didn't have all the gas removed from that fuel tank, and then it could become a dangerous situation.
Disconnect the lines and fittings before removing the valve. Then, for safety, make sure the technician is not in direct line with the valve as it's removed.
After you remove all the lines, the next thing you do is loosen up the mounts.
The tanks can be removed either individually or as a rack or assembly. Safely remove the tank from the vehicle and begin the next step in decommissioning, which is destroying the tank.
The decommissioning of the fuel tank itself is destroying it, basically making it so it's no longer useful as anything that can store high pressure gas. We purge it with nitrogen to drive out any residual natural gas that may be in the fuel tank.
Nitrogen should be used to purge the tank to ensure no fuel remains in the system, that it is completely depressurized. Never use compressed air to purge a tank. Then drill a couple of half-inch holes into the expired tank to prevent reuse.
It's then rendered useless by drilling a hole in the fuel system so that it can never contain pressure anymore.
The labels should also be marked to indicate that the tank is decommissioned. This chapter gives an overview of safe disposal of compressed natural gas fuel tanks. This includes the verification of completed decommissioning, proper disposal of tanks, and documentation of completed disposal. Compressed natural gas tanks that are fully decommissioned are ready for disposal. Be sure that you have accurately documented each step of your established workflow and have verified that the tanks are fully decommissioned before disposal.
Some of them can be recycled. Type 3 tank that has an aluminum liner, that can be recycled. Type 4 tanks, nothing in there to really recycle, they just get disposed of.
Proper disposal depends in part on the materials used in the tank. As always, follow the manufacturer recommendations for this final step in the process and be sure that you have documented the proper disposal of the tank.
The fuel tank manufacturers also is a valuable source of information regarding disposal. In a lot of their manuals for inspection, there's also a section in there regarding how to dispose of them at the end of their life.
It really feels good to work in an industry where you know you're doing good for the environment.
Compressed natural gas is a clean, abundant, cost-effective transportation fuel used in fleets throughout the country. Tanks manufactured for CNG are designed for safety. They have a built-in, thermally activated pressure release device to prevent overpressurization in the event of a fire. They are also designed to achieve a certain number of cycles, but continued maintenance and inspection are critical. As our fleets retire these first waves of expiring tanks, the industry is evaluating the process to further improve safety and efficiency. Know the expiration of the CNG tanks in your fleet.
It's important that that end of life be respected.
Then take the appropriate steps to defuel, decommission, and dispose of them. Clean Cities and its partners in this initiative are available to support you.
Clean Cities, through its stakeholders, has the ability to have a very good outreach network that can reach the different fleet managers and the different coalition stakeholders that are operating natural gas vehicles and helps give them guidance on different things they need to do.
Be informed and be engaged in this process to make sure compressed natural gas remains a viable alternative fuel for our nation's transportation needs long into the future.